And welcome back to Microsoft Virtual Academy. I'm Brennan Matherson, and I'm a product marketing manager at Microsoft, focusing on the Windows Server and System Center data center solutions, and now expanding out into Azure to provide a holistic view for customers to manage their data center more effectively across clouds. The modules that we're in today, or the sessions that we're in today, is called Automation and Self-Service, using Service Manager and Orchestrator. Today's specific topic is self-service for the cloud tenant. So I want to talk about what does that mean from Microsoft's perspective around how we deliver a self-service experience to your enterprise users across the environment. So let's dig into what some of this looks like. Now, for self-service for on-premises solutions, and this is thinking about you have your cloud environment on-premises using Windows Server 2012 R2 and System Center 2012 R2. Some of the things that we want to think about is why are we delivering the solution? Why does it matter and why do you care? Some things that we've identified that we want to talk about are what customers want to do and some things that we've been hearing a lot of feedback within the market around things that are very, very cool, very needed, very necessary in terms of delivering a better service to their environment. One is, I want to think about controlling the changes within their environment. They want to think about managing capacity, whether that's that scaling up or retaining some capacity and reallocating that, managing the status of issues and services that are going on within the environment, and then, of course, managing those incidents and problems that occur or proactively taking action against what may inhibit a better service, quality of service to customers. They want to create a cloud environment, a request compute power or services or resources from the infrastructure across, whether that be on-premises, whether it be through other scenarios that they may want to do within their own niche of the environment. Then they want to find and request services upon need, upon demand. They want to simply deploy some services, deploy some machines, or request some of that capacity or add some users or ensure that permissions are set up appropriately. Many times we're getting a lot of questions around what is the status of my services that are running and what actions do I need to take. We want to know more around that and get more insights into what's occurring. And then we want to just basically manage those costs effectively. And we can do that by reducing those repetitive tasks, those things that we do day by day or even sometimes hour by hour. We want to make sure that we can address that. So how are we doing that and what are we implementing to be able to do that? Self-service provides a number of things, and that's delivered through our service manager portal and through our app controller solution as well. We're able to reduce those manual tasks by automating some processes. We want to find out what all those processes are. That's some work that you'll have to do within IT to identify what are the things that I'm continuing to do every day that I can free up my resource or my staff to do something else that is more critical to meeting the business need. Then I can basically easily request and manage those private clouds and provision those VMs as I need to, because now I've identified which resources I'm going to allow my customers to request. And I have a set rule in who's allowed to do that, and I have the set approvals already in place that I don't need to manually check a box and delay time in case someone's out or in case someone's not available to manually do it. My system has safeguards in place to do that. Then I can standardize my service offerings. That's a big one, because now I identify what is IT going to give back to the business holistically. Which services for which teams? It may vary team by team. What amount of capacity, what amount of storage, what amount of compute, memory, et cetera. I want to think about what are all those attributes that are going to be in play and make sure that I allocate that appropriately. And then I want to have the ability for my users to raise incidents, raise concern. They have their finger on the pulse in terms of the resources that they need, when they need them, and how they need them. So they're able to provide a feedback mechanism to let us know what those issues are so that we can address them. And then we want to increase and decrease capacity to match the project needs. The business is essentially delivering a product to its end customers, and those end customers are getting those services through a number of varying programs or projects. IT is building out an infrastructure to meet those project needs or those program needs. So that's why we want to make sure that we're able to scale upon demand and relatively quickly to be able to meet the needs, so we become more agile, more reliable, and more predictable in terms of how those services are getting deployed. So that's kind of what self-service on-premises delivers for those customers, be able to take control within your own environment. So what does this look like in terms of using the actual self-service experience? Let's take a quick look into what that looks like. Versus resources are built into a cloud infrastructure. And we do that using a service catalog. Let's think of a service catalog as the menu of services that we're going to be delivering across the environment. They can request clouds, they can request capacity, raise incidents. They can see for themselves their own status alerts or the status of the request that they're going to be doing. They can then manage and maintain application resources for those application owners who are going to be actually delivering those services to their individual teams within their unique niche of the world. Now, what is the self-service process that a particular person may get the services that they'll need? So, two different phases, two different views of getting the same type of information. So let's answer a big question. Do you have an existing service management or process that you don't want to lose with an on-premises cloud, private cloud solution? And this is saying, do you have those policies that you've created, those processes that are unique to your organization that may not be standardized across the world, but within your environment, you have all of this work ironed out and you know what that looks like? You can bring that into Service Manager. You can start to bring in all of those approvals, all of those processes, all of those notifications, who needs to be involved, when, where, and why. You've built that in already. Service Manager brings that in. It leverages the CMDB and then takes advantage of the self-service portal to be able to use those resources. Then, another perspective is, do you want to manage an environment for your end users for a project or a program that you're going to be delivering? For instance, you have initiative to build on an application that you're going to be deploying to a website, or you're going to be building out a solution that you're going to be selling to your end customers as a part of one of your broader scenarios. Now you can say, hey, I have a short period of time that I have to have some resources available. I can spin those clouds up or spin those VMs up, manage that storage, manage that compute, manage that memory, and then provide that to my developers or provide that to my engineering teams so that they can proactively work in that environment, and then I can give that back to IT once I'm done. But I didn't have to go through the rigorous process of buying some hardware, getting IT to allocate someone to manage that or provision that hardware, give that hardware to me, I install or do some manual tasks, and then start doing my day-to-day job in terms of getting that project going. That can extend the release cycle, which in turn impacts your delivery time to your end customer. So now we've done this in an automated fashion and using a self-service experience to provision that resource. So that's how we see self-service being provisioned within the environment moving forward if you want to take advantage of Service Manager with Orchestrator on the back end as well as App Controller. Okay, so let's think about this service catalog. Let's take a quick peek into how we envision a service catalog coming into use. We see it in a number of different phases in terms of a controlled empowerment. We want to make sure that we empower our users, but we're also able to control how they access or manage the services that we're going to be delivering to them. It's going to be role-based. Different people on different teams have different access or different needs. So we want to make sure that we build that into the scenarios that we're going to be building out. And then we have a simplified portal. This portal is rendered through the Service Manager self-service portal. And we'll take a look at what that looks like. But that's kind of what we see as a primary view of how we deliver that service through empowerment, managing how those requests are captured and that information that we need to provision the resource, making sure that the people who are within the organization have access to the right resources, and then that we provide them a way to actually experience this and make those requests on their own. Okay, so let's build out a comprehensive service catalog. Let's see just the three attributes of what that looks like. So building out a comprehensive service catalog provides, one, the service offering. The service offering itself is where IT defines what is actually going to be delivered. And this is where we're going to be able to create an offering and then tie a number of request offerings to it. That's the next piece of that. Where the request offering is actually what IT enables a user to actually request. It's not the offering itself, but what are we going to allow someone to request? And I think of it as the service offering as the category, and the request offering is actually the item within that category that they can then select. And then I can apply a number of different parameters to the request offering itself. Let's say if I'm requesting a VM and that's something that I want to do, I can then say, what is the name of that VM? What's the size of the VM? And some other attributes about that service. And then lastly, I can think about the templates themselves, and the request templates are where I can actually provide a way for those requests to be made in an automated fashion, because I have predefined set of offerings or set of requests that I want my users to be able to have access to. And then you'll see that rendered within the service catalog, which is on the self-service portal. Okay. And then you'll see a number of different attributes. You'll see here that within that request of service, and we'll take a bigger view into this catalog or into this portal, you'll be able to identify what are the different offerings that I can then provide or attributes of that VM, if I'm requesting a new VM. So all three of those together is what defines the service catalog, and that helps bring the story together of how I deliver that end-to-end story. So real quick, let me show you what this looks like, and we can take a look at where you can access each one of these three pieces of information, which will be helpful for you to be able to identify what that looks like. All right, so let's step into this demo. I want to show what this looks like in the Service Manager console. We've talked about the service offering. We talk about the request offering. We talk about the templates, which are the key three components of building out the service catalog, because you've already identified what the services may be that you want to deliver to your customers. So I'm stepped into Service Manager. I'm looking at the service catalog. You'll see the number of tabs here on the left side: administration, library, work items, so forth and so on. So I want to go into my library. This is where I build out some of those pieces of data. And I'm going to specifically look at my service catalog, and you'll see request offerings and service offerings. And again, you can have a service offering, think of that as the category, the request offering, or the bite-sized pieces to that. So if I'm going to look at my service offerings, I have a number of offerings that I have here that I've already created. And for instance, I'm going to look at the private cloud infrastructure services. And I've already created this. So let's take a look at what are some of the pieces that you can add within your own environment if you want to take advantage of that. And let me expand this out. Okay. So you have your general tab where I'm going to be able to, of course, the name of that item, the category that it's in, some information about what the request offerings are going to be associated with this service offering, other information that I can apply to this as well. Some costing information, related services, if I want to tie additional services to this, knowledge articles, if I have those as well, and I can show you where we have some of those knowledge articles as well. And then request offerings. Here are the list of minute items, or smallest bit of items that I can allow my users to request. They can request service, they can register a tenant, they can update a virtual machine. And I've created what those offerings look like in terms of the information that we're going to need, when this is published, etc. So that's the actual service offering itself. Again, I can see if I scroll down the left side here, I can scroll to each one of those sections. I want to make sure I publish this. And now I've created my service offering for the private cloud infrastructure services. Now, what are some of those request offerings that sit inside of that? I'll take a look at this. And I have a number of items that I created here. Let's take a look. I want to scroll down. And let's say I want to update a virtual machine. You saw that as one of the items that were listed within that request inside that service offering as well. And again, I've tied a name to this as well. If I want to apply a template to that service as well, I can do that. There's some user prompts. This is key. This is where I prompt my users to bring in the necessary information for me to provision or create that service, where I want to enter the service request title, the urgency of that request. I need to select a virtual machine for that. If I'm going to be updating the owner of that machine, who owns it, or perhaps I need to decommission it or change some other attributes or specs of that virtual machine, I can do that. I can configure those user prompts for how those get surfaced and what pieces of information are going to be asked in terms of RAM, expiration date, total size of the disk, the name of that machine, et cetera, are all things that I'm going to be able to surface and show. And then I can map those to map those prompts as well to various properties, such as who am I going to assign this review, assign the reviewer for that virtual machine request, or am I going to approve that update of the virtual machine request? Those are activities that I'm going to apply that's mapping those prompts to the actions that are going to take place for that request as it gets completed. Okay, so that's the request offering. So I have a number of these offerings. I then tie to the service offering, but let me take a look real quick at the actual templates themselves. As you saw, when we were in the request offering, I was able to apply a template or a service request template to that as well. But let me take a look at that while this continues to close. We're going to open up a template. We're then going to look at one of the ones that we have there now, and as well as if we were to step in and to create a new one. So let's give it a minute to open up. Okay, you'll notice I have a number of activities. I want to do user access reviews or something of that sort. However, I'm going to go ahead and create a new template. I can apply a name to this. All right, and I can provide some information about what this request is, what this template is for. I'm going to then apply a class to it. And this is what identifies the types of services or the types of how we're going to categorize this particular template. And we want this to be a service request. Okay. I press OK. And now I've applied that service request and it's been applied. And now I have this request built. So then it's going to load a form. And then that's where I enter in all my necessary information about the request itself. Request some information, some info about it. I want to make sure that I apply an urgency to this. I want to make sure I set a priority for this as well. I want to make sure I include that. And then I can see more information about the activities. And this is where I start to build out the activities that this request is actually going to perform. And then, of course, I also want to call out any related items if I want to bring in more configuration items or work items related to this request. And again, this is where you'll actually step into a list of those items. Since we already have one created here, I won't step through all of that, but this is where I'll be able to create those items themselves. Now, let me step into what the experience may look like for an end user so that we can see what that looks like. When I'm a user, I sign in as a given user. In this case, I'm Contoso user. I come in and I can actually see all of my categories, or shall we call those service offerings. I have account management, alert management, configuration management, disaster recovery management. And then in the general area, you'll see private cloud infrastructure resources and data center cloud services. So let's say I click into private cloud infrastructure. And I'm a given user. One of the things I want to do, I want to create a request a virtual machine. So within this portal, I can come in and I can request that virtual machine. It'll take me to a request form. And then I want to title this request as a new virtual machine. I've identified the urgency of this request. So now when we were in the previous view within the console as an IT service admin, I was going and creating what are all of these attributes that are tied to this request offering, which is inside of this service offering. The service offering itself, again, was the private cloud infrastructure services, and the request offering is requesting a virtual machine. So now I've identified I have a cloud resource. I needed to create a cloud resource subscription, which I've done, which is a test cloud resource. I've added that. And I want a name for this virtual machine, my VM. Okay. I can enter some information about that if I so choose, and I click Next. And then identify the number of virtual machines that should be created, and then enter the number of the virtual machine suffix. I need to refresh this. I want to make sure that I have some templates that I've already brought in. And I've identified what some of those may be. If I want a previous version of SQL or some other services, I can do that. Click OK. I need to also identify a logical network. I've created that resource as well. I want to be on Group.net. I do that. And then identify the date, and I click Next. Now I want to identify user's request form for the virtual machine where I want to enter the user or the group in terms of who I want to use. So I am Contoso-user. Okay, I'm Contoso-user. And then I have all the information about this request, everything that I created and I applied for this given request. And then I want to hit Submit. So I've now, as a user, as a Contoso user, I've now created this request. It provided me with a request ID or an ID for the service request, and when it was opened, and then I can go back and view my request. Okay. When I do that, I can see a number of requests that I've opened over time, and the activity, if there was one that I canceled. I can see that as well. And here's all the information that I've need. And I've completed the task of going into the service portal, service manager, self-service portal, and created a request. So this is how we've gone through the steps of creating a service offering, creating the request offerings tied to that, applying the templates to that, and then coming into the self-service portal as an end user and performing those steps of requesting those services that IT has allowed me to be able to provision.
And cut.
Okay. All right. So now let's talk about how we're going to be delivering that service. And this is kind of what we just showed. You're going to have your service offering. This is where we're going to have work items that are used to identify and classify the standard IT services. And again, these can contain multiple service or request offerings. And then our next step is then the request offering itself is where these offerings are created by IT and they can then be applied to a service offering and it can be based on a template. We've created a number of templates and then we can apply those templates to the offering itself. Then we use those templates to bring in standardized data and standardize the process for making those requests, and then we deploy those to the service catalog itself. So that's where we're going to be able to see how those request offerings can then be applied to service offerings and then deliver end-to-end process where we create the service offering. We can create a service request template. We can publish that offering, create the request offering. We can then make sure we publish that offering. We make sure we publish both the request offering and the service offering. And then we add those to the service catalog. And then that's how those are provided in the environment. Okay. So as you just saw when we were just in our view for the service offering, there's a number of things. We want to make sure that, just as we just mentioned, it contains a number of those pieces of information, but it provides a consistent delivery of service-related details, which include knowledge articles, service-level agreement information, and you can also apply some costing and chargeback information, related information to that as well. We want to make sure that we create a service offering that then we can show the general page for where they can see general information about that and then drill down into more specific information tied to the user or tied to the related services or tied to the history and then make sure that it's published. We want to make sure that that's a key part of this. Now, the request offerings are where we're going to apply based on a template, or we can provide those user prompts where we give input or free field information or list, or we can do query-based lists, or we can bring in CMDB objects or configuration management database objects, and then other types of input based on the need that we have for that information. We also want to define the mapping of user responses to the properties that we want to bring into the service request or the incident that is being created. And that's a key piece there that it can also be part of what we do for when our service requests when users request services or request fixes from incidents. So we're going to create the request offering. We can see the general page where there's more information about just the overall view of the offering itself. We can show user prompts on that page. We can configure the prompts as needed. And then we can show the configuration of those prompts, and then we need to publish that information. Then when we think about the templates themselves, we've created a number of templates there, and you can do the same to standardize how we capture data from the users that are going to be requesting services, because we know that we want to deliver the same service in the same fashion all the time. The scope or the scale of the actual requests may vary, and that's where we allow user-based information about that. But that can be used to create or update an object, and the request offerings can be based on those templates to be able to provide that information in a repetitive fashion. And again, the steps for that are going into the Service Manager console, and then you create those templates under the template section within that library. You're then able to provide the service request template form where you fill out all the necessary information about that request, and then you have a manual activity form that you want to apply as well, and that will provide information about the manual steps that it's going to take to see that request through to the end when it's requested. Okay. So, as we think about how we provide the service catalog as we deploy some services, we want to make sure that we bring all of the components or the resources together to be able to deliver that, in which a service offering with one or more request offerings can be based on those templates, and those service catalog can be ready via the Service Manager portal. And that allows IT to provision the portal effectively, and it can be based on a user because a user can see various parts of that catalog as needed. So IT just needs to create an entire catalog of all the offerings that they want, and then they can deploy that catalog and define who gets to use those services. So we're going to create that service offering, create that service request, we're going to publish that information, provide that request offering, and then we can continue to add on more request offerings as needed to a various number of service offerings through that service catalog, or through the self-service portal, through the service portal. So that's how we're going to actually deploy that service catalog, and we're able to see how that gets deployed. So that sums up what the attributes are of the self-service catalog, or the self-service experience, and how we build out that offering, those offerings for customers. As we continue on, we're going to continue to talk about how we expand that to more offerings. But one of the things we want to take away from this is the actual additional resources that you have available to you through TechNet, being able to go onto the Download Center and let's try out this software with Service Manager and Orchestrator and start to play with some of these service offerings and build out your self-service experience. You can also try this on our virtual labs, and we have our TechNet virtual labs where you can do a hands-on technical labs that are self-paced environment that you can then play with and learn about what the actual steps are. And then, of course, continue on with the Microsoft Virtual Academy. This has been automation and self-service and building out a self-service experience for your customers. Thanks again, and please follow along for our next module in the automation and self-service experience. Thank you.